I'm asked time and again by people who work hard, whose strength is used up in the course of a working day, and who cannot start a day with reading long prayers in order to have fulfilled what they think is their obligation to God. And it is about this that I want to say a few words. First of all, forget about any obligation to God.
And what he expects of us is a response of our heart, love in response to God, not a sense of obligation that because he is our Lord and God, we must do what we will love, but the sense that we are so happy to have a God who loves us. And the Lord, the God who does love us not only in words, who has proved that he loves us fully, because no one has a greater love than he who lays down his life for those who are dear to him. And this is what God has done in Christ. He has laid down his life for each of us, for all of us. Not for all of us collectively, but for all of us singly, for each. There is this story in the lives of saints of a priest who was so horrified at the unworthiness of his contemporary Christians, indeed of himself also, that he turned to God and said, "How long, O Lord, how long are you going to endure us? Come and judge us rightly." And Christ appeared to him and said, "Never pray such a prayer. If there was only one sinner in the world, I would become man again and die on the cross for him alone." This is the God to whom we come in prayer. Not a God who needs our prayers. He has heard these prayers which are in our prayer books for centuries. The first time they gushed out of the soul of living men and women like blood out of the wound. A cry of repentance. A cry of gratitude. Tears and laughter. Horror and a sense of glory. But since they have been repeated time and again through the centuries with people who have reached more or less, at times a prayer reaches us, hits us at the heart. Have mercy on your Lord. At times we can say that with all our being, but at times we simply rehearse a song, and that God is in no need of. When he really shouted these words, when they ran out of him like blood out of the wound, oh yes, they have power to reach you. Not the monotonous and boring way in which you may recite your times. So what matters to us is to turn not to a God who expects us to sing his praises or to express feelings which we should have and which very often we have not got, but a sincere and direct relationship. Think of what happens in the morning. You're awake. You enter into a new day. And what is this awakening a new day? We are every morning when we awake from our night's sleep, like Lazarus being called out of the grave. Our sleep has been to us an image of our life in death, resting of a long life or a short life, and being called into a new life. And we enter into a new day that has never existed before. It's not an old day that reappears. It's a new day. It stretches itself before us like a plain covered in snow, pure, unstained, unmarked by human steps. And God says, walk. Enter into this perfect purity of a new day and walk through it without soiling it. Your steps will be marked, but if they are right, there will be a path which others will follow. There will be a way, and I am the way. This is how we should enter into a new day. Say, Lord, bless me to be a new creature in a day that has never existed before. And what shall I meet in the course of this day? I will meet circumstances, and I need people. Circumstances are always embodied in human beings. And we can ask ourselves, who are these beings? Who among them are of any importance? What action matters? What time matters? And again, in the lives of saints and in the legends of men, there is the story of a child who was asked the same question. Who is the most important person in my life? And the child answered, but the one with whom I am now, because now there is no other person. And what is the most important moment in life then? The present moment. The moment when I'm with this person. There is no other moment. And what is the most important thing I can do in life then? Do the right thing at this moment for this person. If we thought that way, whenever we meet a person, whenever we enter into the newness of life, how rich and productive our life would be. And if, having entered into a new day, the way I have said, if we had thought that the person with whom I am now is the only person and therefore the most important person in creation, that this present moment is the only moment, and what I can do, ill or well, is what matters. How creative and rich our life would be. And when we come to the end of the day, we stand face to face with God, who says, I have been with you all the time. There were a few moments when you remembered me, and you were my voice, and my hands, and my eyes, and my ears. But how often it has happened that you forgot all about it, and about the place you have in life. And then you can turn to God and say, yes, it is true. This day, I have missed. It has passed by me, uselessly, meaninglessly. What shall I do? And the Lord answered me, are you really aware of this? If you are aware, are you heartbroken? If you are heartbroken, are you prepared never as far as your ability goes? Are you prepared never to be the same as you were today? And we must say, yes, Lord, I have been wrong today. I have betrayed my vocation. I have betrayed your love for me and for the others. I will reflect on that. Not by reading other people's prayers, but by thinking about that own day. This day that was the Lord's own day. And also, turning for help to the prayers of saints in which they have expressed their distress and their unfaithfulness to their vocation, and learn from them how heartbroken a saint can be when we are so seldom heartbroken, because it takes a saint to have this perceptiveness, this sense of good and evil, and from them we can learn. And so if we start our day as Lazarus being called out of the tomb and called into a day that has never existed to meet one person after the other, that at that moment will be the only one, as a moment will be the only one, and action will be the only right one or the wrong one, then we can start the day with the Lord, continue it with Him, and in the end, face Him at the end of it. Face Him brokenheartedly and at the same time with such sense of joy. Lord, I'm unworthy, and you still love me. You still can love me. Not sentimentally, tenderly, and at the price of your own life. I can trust your love, because that is its merit. Let us learn to start the day and to end it in a way a little similar to what I have said, because there is little I understand, but the little I have understood, I am trying to convey to you. And may the blessing of the Lord be upon you, by His grace and love for mankind, always, now and forever, and world without end.